Hey guys, and welcome back to Liftoff, your first place where you find everything space, Elon Musk, Tesla, and SpaceX. Elon Musk may be in the news for his interest in Twitter, but it's his tweet about lithium that may prove the most consequential, as the price for the rare metal surges. Price of lithium has gone to insane levels. Tesla might actually have to get into the mining and refining directly at scale unless costs improve, the Tesla founder tweeted this month. There are no further reported developments on Tesla's plans for lithium mining, but as Mr. Musk pointed out, despite being called rare, metal lithium is not scarce. It's, however, used extensively in the batteries that underpin electrification, and demand is far outpacing supply. The cost of lithium, which rose nearly fourfold in the past year, according to an index of global prices compiled by Benchmark Mineral Intelligence, jeopardizes the transition from fossil fuels to electric power and renewables. While lithium has been dragged into the turmoil surrounding commodities after Russia's invasion of Ukraine, prices were already soaring before the war as demand surged amid a global race to net zero emissions and the pandemic disrupted supply chains. With electric car sales continuing to grow around the world, some countries have begun to take urgent action to counter runaway price raises and a supply crunch. In the U.S., President Joe Biden last month invoked the Defense Production Act, a Cold War-era law that gives him sweeping emergency powers to control domestic industries, in an effort to shore up domestic supplies of lithium and other critical minerals in the battery supply chain, such as nickel, cobalt, manganese, and graphite. And in China, by far the world's largest consumer of lithium, the government has reportedly begun telling companies involved in electric vehicle production that it wants the cost of the metal to return to sustainable levels, as soaring prices have increased inflation for manufacturers and threatened to eventually hurt consumer demand. But will lithium production ever be able to meet demand as countries around the world aim for net zero emission targets? Well, batteries are a key driver of lithium and other metals, and currently there's a supply squeeze, partly driven by Russia invading Ukraine, but also by a big pickup in demand over the last few years, said Ben Yearsley, a British investment director tracking global energy markets. I don't think supply can keep up with demand, which means one of two things. Either we slow the pace of decarbonization, which seems to be politicians' favorite route currently, or you pay more for it. Either way, that doesn't get more metal out of the ground, he told The National. Hinting at a possible silver lining to the solution, Mr. Yearsley said, the Russia-Ukraine war shows how important energy security is. That's actually fairly good for decarbonization, with things like wind power abundant. However, lots of ingredients needed are from conflicted areas. Demand for electric cars has been held up, even as the cost of producing the lithium-ion batteries that power them jumped by more than 50% in the first quarter of 2022 over the previous years. Environmental concerns and rising fuel costs since the war began in Ukraine are pushing more consumers toward buying electric vehicles, despite their higher sticker prices. Experts say the demand is likely only to grow from there. The development and increase in sales of electric vehicles certainly affects the need for raw materials. The demand for critical minerals will increase, said Ahmad Hanan, a researcher in energy security at the Purnomo Yusjayantoro Center, a think tank in Indonesia. The most significant demand comes from China because it's the owner of the most electric vehicle manufacturers globally, he told The National. Beyond electric car production, lithium and other critical minerals have emerged as vital resources in the transition away from fossil fuels. The rapid pace of electrification has created what some have called a white gold rush, with the potential to create new global energy superpowers. We know that the need for critical minerals will increase as the energy transition continues in the future, said Mr. Hanan. Countries with abundant reserves and critical minerals production will dominate the world supply chain geographically, he said, with the projected value of the lithium-ion battery market projected to grow from $44.49 billion in 2021 to $193.13 billion by 2028, according to research from Fortune Business Insights. Establishing secure supplies of lithium is now a strategic aim for many states. Lithium supply security has become a top priority for Asia, Europe, and the U.S. technology companies, said Mr. Hanan. Strategic alliances and joint ventures among technology companies and exploration companies continue to be established to ensure a reliable, diversified supply of lithium for battery and vehicle manufacturers. Where does lithium come from? The world's supply of lithium comes mostly from hard rock mines and reservoirs of highly salty water, or brine, found beneath dried lakes. 4 mineral operations in Australia, 2 brine operations each in Argentina and Chile, and 2 brine and 1 mineral operation in China accounted for most world lithium production, said Mr. Hanan. Smaller operations in Brazil, China, Portugal, the United States, and Zimbabwe also contributed to world lithium production. In hard rock mining, lithium is extracted from the ground and then heated using fossil fuels, releasing large amounts of carbon dioxide and harming the environment. The process requires large quantities of water. Extracting lithium from brine is also energy intensive and requires water in ample quantities in places where it's often scarce. But lithium can also be found in high concentrations in geothermal waters, underground reservoirs that are heated naturally from within the earth. Hot, salty waters pump to the surface and can yield lithium and also generate electricity. In Germany, Britain, and the United States, efforts to begin extracting lithium from these geothermal waters are well underway, giving hope to some that the environmental effects of lithium production could be drastically reduced. What will EV battery pricing be like in the near future? All right, so within the first week of the year, prices for battery-grade lithium carbonate in China jumped to a record high of $41,060 per ton, more than 5 times higher than last January. Other commodities used in cathodes, such as cobalt, have also been rising. The price of cobalt doubled since last January to $70,208 a ton, that's US dollars, while nickel jumped 15% year-on-year. S&P Global Market Intelligence forecasts that lithium supply is expected to jump to 636,000 tons of lithium carbonate equivalent in 2022, up from an estimated 497,000 in 2021. Demand's even expected to jump even higher to 641,000 tons from an estimated 504,000. Separately, Fitch in a recent report said lithium supply will face a number of vulnerabilities, including geographical concentration at both the mining and refining level, as well as the limited presence of established and large mining players. How automakers are fighting the battery crisis. Energy research and consulting firm Wood Mackenzie estimates that electric vehicles will make up 18% of new car sales by 2030. That would increase the demand for batteries by about 8 times as much as factories can currently produce. The upside is that car makers are in an intense race to acquire the right recipe that will deliver the most energy at the lowest price and in the smallest package. All right. That's all the information we have for you today. I hope you enjoyed today's video and learned lots. If you want to see more about space, SpaceX, Elon Musk, and Tesla, and all this sort of technology news, of course, make sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications. Thank you for watching, and we'll catch you next time.